John Lucas is in there to try the extra point. And number 30, Dan Rinaldi, has called a timeout to see what they want to do right here. And we'll take a pause in the action with 9:47 left in the first period on a Dan Rinaldi 25-yard run. Acton Boxborough up by a score of 6-0. Return to action after a Dan Rinaldi 25-yard TD run. The attempt for extra point will be tried by number 10, John Lucas. Holder will be number 15, Andy Butler. Here's the snap. It's up. And it splits the uprights. The kick is good. And the score, with 9 minutes and 47 seconds left in the first period, Acton Boxborough has jumped out in front by a score of 7-0. Let's give some credit to that interior line opening up a huge hole for Dan Rinaldi on that touchdown run. Center, number 55, Sammy Martin. Number 66, right guard, Paul Trischetta. Left guard, number 71, Sean Richmond. Right tackle was number 52, Devin Colloy. Left tackle was number 77, Ryan Messina, helped out by tight end number 89, Matt Stampski.
In a big game like this, Pete, it's great to see Acton come out with the intensity needed to get the ball in the end zone first. It'll give them a tremendous boost to carry on into the game.
Okay, I'm told in that last touchdown play, it was number 78, Paul Sweeney, in at right tackle, not number 52, Devin Colloy. Let's give Mr. Paul Sweeney credit. Teeing up the ball for Acton Boxborough will be number 10, John Lucas. Back deep to receive for Lincoln Sudbury will be number 33, Tyrone Croom, and number 43, Jason Senegal. The kick is fielded by number 33. He's going to break it. There's one tackler left. And John Lucas not only stayed at home, but he also caused a flag in the play. The kickoff was fielded by number 33, Tyrone Croom. There is a flag on the kickoff. The ball was returned from about the 20 out to about the 47-yard line. We have a clipping call against Lincoln Sudbury. That will be a 15-yard spot foul. 15 yards will be assessed against Lincoln Sudbury. But there's again the concern of Coach Maver, the special teams, the explosiveness of the offensive backs of Lincoln Sudbury. Tyrone Croom almost broke that one off, except for a clip, and it looked as though John Lucas was in position to make a tackle, but Tyrone tripped more than he was tackled. So it'll be Lincoln Sudbury's ball, first and 10 from their own 32-yard line. Inside handoff to number 34, Mark Whipple, for Lincoln Sudbury. He's going to pick up about 4 or 5 on the play. And in the stop for Acton Boxborough is number 66, Paul Trischetta. Let's give Mr. Whipple a 5-yard gain. That last play will be 2nd and 5. Inside handoff to number 33, Tyrone Croom. He's going to be met right at the line of scrimmage by that left defensive side, led by number 71, Sean Richmond, and number 66, Paul Trischetta, joined by number 89, Matt Stampski.
Sudbury running a double tight formation, Pete, with a full house backfield. They clearly want to come out and a ground game.
It will be 3rd and 3 for Lincoln Sudbury at their own 37-yard line. Pass is complete to number 42, Brendan Glass. It will give Lincoln Sudbury a first down at their own 47-yard line. In the stop for Acton Boxborough is number 71, Sean Richmond. However, that does give Lincoln Sudbury a first down, and they'll now operate from their own 48, 49-yard line, 1st and 10. Hand off to number 34, Mark Whipple. He's going to pick up close to a first down. He's tackled by number 30, Dan Rinaldi. He did pick up enough for a first down. And Lincoln's is giving a quick answer to that Dan Rinaldi touchdown as they've gained two first downs consecutively right here. It's now first and 10 at the Acton Boxborough 41-yard line. The Acton defense has been relatively very stingy all year long, but they're playing the powerhouse Lincoln Sudbury. Ball's carried by number 34, Mark Whipple, originally hit by number 66, Paul Truschetta, then game tackled by number 71, Sean Richmond. Pick up of maybe two or three in the play, bring up second and about seven. We have 7 minutes and 32 seconds left in the first period. Here's the bootleg action by number 10, Hunter. He delivers the ball out here to number 3, Tyrone Kroom. The pass is complete. A pickup of about 20 on the play. The ball will now be spotted at the Acton Boxborough 18-yard line. In on the stop for Acton Boxborough was number 71, Sean Richmond. We have 7 minutes even in the left in the first period with the score. Acton Boxborough 7, Lincoln Sudbury 0, but Lincoln Sudbury on a drive.
Hey, Mike.
Fumble on the play. It is recovered by Acton Boxborough. The ball was recovered by number 66, Paul Truschetta. A big first quarter turnover for Lincoln Sudbury with 6 minutes and 46 seconds left in the first period. Lincoln Sudbury was on a dangerous, threatening drive, but turned the ball over at the Boxborough 15. Ryan Kane will continue at quarterback for Acton Boxborough. The handoff is to number 35, Chris Mahaney. He's going to pick up about six on the play. There is a flag on the play, however. Usually thrown by in the interior line, it would be offensive holding. And we do have offensive holding against Acton Boxborough. That will nullify the six-yard gain by number 35, Chris Mahaney. That will be a 10-yard penalty, but I think they'll split the difference here because they're inside the 20. So it'll go half the distance to the goal line here. So it's going to bring up about a second and about 18. We'll see where they spot the ball. A very nice crowd on hand tonight, again, for this very important Duke County League football game. This will probably determine the representative in the MIAA playoff format created this year. The ball will be spotted at the Acton Boxborough 8-yard line. And it will make it about first and about 20. We have 6 minutes and 30 seconds left in the first period. Kane's inside handoff is number 42, A.J. Pittorino. He's able to break a few tackles at the line of scrimmage and bring it out to the original line of scrimmage. A gain of about 9 on the play. It's going to bring up second and 11, maybe 12 yards to go.
Pete, what you're seeing, the straight ahead plays, either the dive plays or the slant plays to the tackle are more effective tonight, I think, than you're going to see the counter plays, which the boys are likely to slip in the dirt out here on the mud.
At this point in time, Acton Boxborough's Coach Mayer is going to go to a double tight. He's going to bring number 80, Chris Varney, into the ball game, and he'll be the other split end, tight end, along with Matt Stamsky, number 89. That's Chris Mahaney going in motion. The pitch is going to be to number 33, Lance Pitcher. He follows the blocking of number 30, Dan Rinaldi, and number 71, Sean Richmond. A gain of maybe 2 on the play. That's going to bring up a 3rd and 9. We have 5 minutes and 25 seconds left in the first period. Acton Boxborough up by a score of 7-0 on a 25-yard TD run by tri-captain Dan Rinaldi. The extra point by number 10, John Lucas, was successful. Splitting out to left is number 10, John Lucas, and the slot will be number 9, Trey Gulledge. Ryan Kane on the draw, quick draw play to number 42, A.J. Pittorino, is sniffed out by the Lincoln Sudbury defense. In an attack for Lincoln Sudbury, 43, Jason Senegal. And that will bring up a fourth and about 10 for Acton Boxborough. Going in punt formation will be number 10, John Lucas. Back deep to receive the punt will be number 33, Tyrone Croom. Coach Maver worked very hard on special teams this week. See if he kicks it high and away from Tyrone. The ball is going to be fielded very cleanly and quickly by Tyrone Croom. And he's going to return the ball back for about a 25-yard punt return. That punt there was low, a low line drive kick fielded cleanly by Tyrone Croom. And right now, Lincoln Sudbury playing excellent field position. They'll be at the Acton Boxborough 25-yard line. In the tackle for Acton Boxborough was number 64, Bill Taylor. So Lincoln Sudbury will operate from the Acton 25-yard line. Pitch goes to number 34, Mark Whipple. He's going to be brought down from behind by pursuing defensive tackle number 80, Chris Varney. A loss of one on the play. That'll bring up a second and 11 with 4 minutes and 5 seconds left in the first period. Excellent pursuit there by the big defensive tackle of Acton Boxborough, number 80, Chris Varney. Handoff will go to number 33. Tyrone Croom in the tackle for Acton Boxborough with number 66, Paul Truschetta. A pickup of maybe four on the play. It's going to bring up a third and 7.
Both coaches, Peter, want to dominate on the offensive line with a double tight end formation. They're really trying to play smash mouth football, as you saw last week against Bedford.
Well, that's usually the case for two fine football teams, that the team that dominates the line of scrimmage is going to win the ball game. Hunter's going to drop straight back to pass, delivers the ball over the middle, intended for number 41, Chuck Rice, is going to fall incomplete. And on the coverage for Acton Boxborough was number 30, Dan Rinaldi, joined by number 10, John Lucas. That will bring up a 4th and 7 for Lincoln Sudbury. They do have an excellent field goal kicker in number 25, Kevin Bedard. Observing him in the pregame workouts, he was drilling him from about 35 yards away. Coach Lopez thinks he's a little bit too far out. He's going to go for it on 4th and about 7. Hunter on the draw play to number 33, Tyrone Croom. He's going to take it out. Some exceptional running by number 33, Tyrone Croom. It looked like they had him stop short of the first down, but he spun off and then picked up enough for a first down. A great bit of running there by number 33, Tyrone Croom. That will be a 1st and 10 at the 11-yard line of Acton Boxborough. There are 2 minutes and 50 seconds left in the first period. A great run there by number 33, Tyrone Croom of Lincoln Sudbury. Handoff will go to number 34, Mark Whipple. He's going to bring it down to about the 6, so it'll be a pickup of about 5 on the play. Be 2nd and 5. In the stop for Acton Boxborough is number 42, A.J. Pitorino, along with number 35, Chris Mahaney. Acton Boxborough making some substitutions here. Into the lineup will be number 68, Mark Nagy, along with number 78, Paul Sweeney. Whipple on the carry, again a second effort. Looked like he was hit behind the line of scrimmage by number 89, Matt Stamsky, but he kept his feet and bowled his way for about a 2-yard gain. That'll bring up a 3rd and about 3 at the Acton Boxborough 4-yard line. Some tough running by the great backs of Lincoln Sudbury. We have 1 minute and 40 seconds left with Lincoln Sudbury threatening to put the ball over here to tie up the score. That's number 10, Hunter, a quarterback. He's going to pitch it out to number 33, Tyrone Croom. He's in. And with 1 minute and 24 seconds left, Lincoln Sudbury has got on the board. It will be Greensboro 7, Lincoln Sudbury 6. And now we'll have the try for the extra point by number 25, Kevin Bedard. Lincoln Sudbury showing their perseverance right there. They had a turnover. The defense held fast and made Acton punt it. Tyrone Kroom returned it for about 25 yards, and they just punched it over. That's Bedard's attempt for extra point. It is good. And with 1 minute and 24 seconds left in the first period, it is Acton Boxborough 7, Lincoln Sudbury 7.
Sudbury showed a great deal of patience in that drive, Pete. Every time Acton countered with one defensive change, Sudbury came back with a different play, whether it was inside or outside. It's a good chess match we've got out here between the two coaches.
Well, again, Lincoln Sudbury is probably a very strong club, well coached by Tom Lopez. They're not going to get down on themselves just because Acton Boxborough came out with a quick score. Acton Boxborough needs to, hang in there, put another score across, and keep challenging Lincoln Sudbury. This is going to be a tough, tough football game all night long. Neither side is going to give in. They know the importance of this game. Teeing the ball up for Lincoln Sudbury will be number 25, Kevin Bedard. Back deep to receive for Acton Boxborough will be number 42, A.J. Pitorino, and number 34, Jason Brady. Tonight is also Pop Warner night. The young aspiring football players involved with the Acton Boxborough Pop Warner will be introduced at halftime, along with the cheerleaders. The ball is going to be fielded by number 42, A.J. Pitorino, at the 5. He initially stumbles. Now he's going to try to cut it outside, and he's going to bring it out to about the 21-yard line. So it'll be a 16-yard return by number 42, A.J. Pitorino. Ball is spotted at the 21. It will be Acton Boxborough ball. I see number 12 trotting out to the field. That will be tri-captain Ryan Kane. He will remain at quarterback for Acton Boxborough. There is 1 minute and 17 seconds left in the first period. It'll be first and 10 at the 21 of Acton. It is the inside handoff to number 42, A.J. Pitorino. He's greeted very rudely at the line of scrimmage by number 54, Kevin Dolan, and number 56, Greg Shaw.
No coincidence, those are the two Sudbury captains, Pete. They're good defensive ball players.
They will be a loss in a play of about one to bring up a second and 11. Again, the trademark of all strong teams is the defensive front four and how they can dominate that line of scrimmage. Lincoln Sudbury showing why they're considered one of the top teams in the state. Inside hand, number 30, Dan Rinaldi. He chugs his way out for about 3 yards. It'll bring up a second and 8. In the stop for Lincoln Sudbury was number 56, Greg Shaw, and number 54, Kevin Dolan, the co-captains of Lincoln Sudbury. Hand off to number 42, A.J. Pitorino. He breaks a couple of tackles, but he's going to pick up about 3 on the play. It's going to bring up a 4th down and about 5. In and the stop again for, Lincoln Sudbury. We number 56, Greg Shaw. And that's the end of the first period with the score, Acton Boxborough 7, the Lincoln Sudbury Warriors 7. We'll return to action in a brief moment. As we're between quarters here, we're getting a nice show put on by the Acton Boxborough cheerleaders, and I'll take a moment to introduce them. There we have Amy Herman and assistant captain Lydia Richardson. Right now we're going to return to action with number 10, John Lucas, back in deep punt formation. And the receiving end will be number 33, Tyrone Kroom. The snap is good, handled cleanly by number 10, John Lucas. He does get off a high punt. It takes a favorable Acton bounce. They're going to pick up an additional 12 yards on the bounce. The ball will be laid dead at the Lincoln Sudbury 39-yard line. So it'll be first and 10 for the Warriors. I'm sure we'll have another chance to view the Acton Boxborough cheerleaders, and I'll give you their names when that time arises. We have first and 10 for Lincoln Sudbury at their own 39-yard line. There are 10 minutes and 50 seconds left in the half. The score is Acton Boxborough 7, Lincoln Sudbury 7. Number 34, Mark Whipple takes the ball from number 10, Hunter, for Lincoln Sudbury. He's going to pick up about 6 in the play. Into the tackle for Acton Boxborough was number 71, Sean Richmond. And number 10, Lucas. It'll bring up a second and 4. The ball is spotted. The nose of the ball is spotted right at the 45 of Lincoln Sudbury. Acton Boxborough needs to show that they can stop Lincoln Sudbury on the ground here. Otherwise, Lincoln Sudbury's going to have a pretty big night. Here's the counter play. The inside hand out to number 33, Tyrone Croom. Chris Varney was almost able to penetrate before Hunter could make the playoff, make the handoff, but he did make a successful handoff. A pickup of about 7 on the play. There'll be a first down for Lincoln Sudbury. The ball will now be spotted at the Acton Boxborough 47. The interior line of Acton Boxborough must have had a stunt on there because Chris Varney penetrated very quickly and almost was able to disrupt the handoff. Here's the bootleg action by number 10, Hunter, delivered out here to number 34, Mark Whipple. He's going to be driven out of bounds by number 33, Lance Pitcher. That will be close to a first down. And they will pick up a first down. The ball is now spotted at the Acton Boxborough 36-yard line. Again, Acton Boxborough has not shown that they can stop the Lincoln Sudbury. Each time that Lincoln Sudbury has the ball, they've driven the ball. The first time the drive was nullified by a fumble. The second possession, they took it on a long march and put it in the end zone. Here's the pitch wide to number 33, Tyrone Croom. He's going to be dragged down by number 42, A.J. Pitterino, joined by teammate number 34, Jason Brady.
Sudbury's offense, Pete, even though they're lining up double tight and with a full house backfield, they do have the quickness to hide behind the tackle in the end and get outside. Or they've, on the rollout pass there, they had a moving pocket. The tackle in the end moved out. They're looking straight forward, but they're doing some clever things off of it.
Yeah, they have a tight formation, but they're with their speed, they're able to put additional pressure by being able to go outside. That's number 42, the ball carrier, Brendan Glass for LS. And then the tackle for Acton Boxborough is number 42, A.J. Pitterino. A pickup of maybe 3 in the play. They'll bring up a third and a long 3. We have 9 minutes and about 8 seconds left in the half. Again, Lincoln Sudbury on another long drive. Number 34, Mark Whipple, the ball carrier. He's going to be met by the right side, right defensive side of Acton Boxborough. He's going to pick up close to a first down. Number 71 slowly getting up. Sean Richmond, one of the tacklers. He was joined by number 34, Mahaney, and number 34, Jason Brady. However, that's another first down for Lincoln Sudbury. And then they're on another sustained drive. It'll be first and 10 for Lincoln Sudbury at the Acton Boxborough 25.
Good timeout by Acton at that point. Some of the players, as you saw, some substitutions going in with a little bit of heat tonight. Coach Maver taking advantage of this and calling a smart timeout.
Well, also, he's going to talk to his troops, calm them down here a little bit. Lincoln Sudbury has shown a tenacious drive. Every time they've had the ball, they've had this is their third possession. And Acton Boxborough has shown no signs of slowing them down. With 8 minutes and 50 seconds left in the half, we'll take a brief pause in the action. We've returned to action. It's first and 10 for Lincoln Sudbury at the Acton Boxborough 25-yard line. Hunter hands off to number 33, Tyrone Croom. A great job of containment by number 89, Matt Stamsky, And he's joined by his friend line of Acton Boxborough by number 66, Paul Trusketter, and middle inside linebacker number 71, tri-captain Sean Richmond. A loss of one on the play. It's coming up a second and 11. The dive handoff to number 33, Dyron Croom. Just a straight dive play, but he showed excellent balance, excellent speed as he broke a couple of tackles, put on a spin move, and broke the ball all the way down to the 5-yard line of Acton Boxborough. We have 8 minutes and 10 seconds left in the half, and Lincoln Sudbury is again threatening to score. It'll be first and goal at the 5. Inside handoff to number 34. He's going to break it outside. Number 34, Matt Whipple. And he stopped just outside at about the 1. He's brought out of bounds by number 33, Lance Pitcher, joined by number 66, Paul Trusketta. Again, the backs of Lincoln Sudbury showing tremendous balance and leg power. They're initially hit at the line of scrimmage. They're either breaking the tackle or at least picking up 2 or 3 extra yards, even though they're hit. Inside handoff to number 33, Tyrone Croom, touchdown. He deserved that one. He had some excellent runs on that drive, and Tyrone Croom will have a 1-yard TD run credited next to his name. And we have 11 minutes and 7 seconds left in the half, with Sudbury up by a score of 13-7.
Key to that drive, Pete, was Sudbury's ability to mix up their play calling. They pulled guards in some plays, they blocked down in others. They got things going their way to where a dive play all of a sudden becomes very effective straight ahead.
Here's the extra point fake. Hunter, the quarterback, going to keep. He's going to deliver the ball out to number 84, Matt Williams, and a 2-point conversion will be good. And that could loom very big later on in the ball game. And with 7 minutes and 11 seconds left in the first half, it is Lincoln Sudbury 15, Acton Boxborough 7. We'll take a brief pause in the action. Teeing up the ball for Lincoln Sudbury will be number 25, Kevin Bedard. Back deep to receive for Acton Boxborough will be number 42, A.J. Pinarino, and number 34, Jason Brady. After an early score by Acton Boxborough on their first possession, Lincoln Sudbury has responded and responded well. They put 2 TDs in of their own and are up by a score of 15-7. Number 42, A.J. Pinarino, will finally pick it up. He breaks an initial tackle, but he's going to be brought down by number 40 of Lincoln Sudbury. That'll be Dave Wren. Again, Lincoln Sudbury playing field position here. They have Acton Boxborough boxed in at their own end. They're going to operate at their own 10-yard line. It'll be first and 10 for Acton Boxborough with 7 minutes and 2 seconds left. Acton Boxborough again with poor field position. Number 12, tri-captain Ryan Kane will remain at quarterback. Here's the play-action pass. The pass delivered out here to number 89, Matt Stamsky. He keeps his feet after a big hit by number 42, Brendan Glass. But Matt Stamsky showed great hands there, and then he took a punishing hit by number 42, Brendan Glass, but kept his feet and gained an extra 2 or 3 yards. So that was a pickup of 15 on the play. It will be first and 10 now from the Acton 25-yard line. Inside handoff to number 42, A.J. Pinarino. He follows the inside blocking of his interior line, led by number 55, Sammy Martin, and number 66, Paul Trusketta. A pickup of 7 on the play. It's going to bring up a 2nd and 3. In the tackle for Lincoln Sudbury was number 41, Chuck Rice. Again, both football teams are just going to say, we're going to run it right at you. Let's see if you can stop us. Inside hand, 30, Dan Rinaldi. He's going to ball his way out close to a first down. He's going to be brought down by number 50 of Lincoln Sudbury, Brett Kala. He's going to be joined by number 54, Kevin Dolan.
From the start of the game, Coach Lopez has switched Kevin Dolan back into nose guard, Pete. I think they feel more comfortable with him in there.
The official did give Dan credit for a first down, so it will be first and 10 just outside the Acton-Boxborough 35-yard line. Inside handoff to number 35, Chris Mahaney. Again, he followed the exceptional blocking on the right side by his right tackle, number 78, Paul Sweeney, and number 64, Billy Taylor. A pickup of 9 on the play. It's going to be second and 1. The tackler again for Lincoln Sudbury was number 41, Chuck Rice. We have 4 minutes and 13 seconds left in the half. Acton-Boxborough putting together a little drive of their own right here, trying to respond by two consecutive scores of Lincoln Sudbury. Ryan Kane back to pass. It was delivered out to number 9, Trey Gulich. The defender close to him had tripped, but Ryan Kane delivered the ball maybe a tad prematurely. That will bring up a 3rd and 1 at the Acton-Boxborough 44-yard line. Inside handoff to number 30, Dan Rinaldi. He keeps his feet, and the official will spot it just beyond the 45-yard line. It'll be very close to a first down. In the stop for Lincoln Sudbury is number 50, Brett Kala. They will give credit for a first down, and that will keep the drive alive. There are now 4 minutes and 53 seconds left in the half. First and 10 at the Acton 46-yard line. Kane on the handoff to number 42, A.J. Pellerino. Breaks one tackle, and there's a fumble on the play. The official has not indicated who fumbled the ball, or maybe the ball just went out of bounds without being touched. A.J. Pellerino had gained about 3 in the play, but with the fumble, the ball is going to be spotted for about a 2-yard gain. So it'll bring up a 2nd and 8. The initial hit was made by number 41, Chuck Rice of Lincoln Sudbury. Then number 33, Tyrone Kroom, came up and finished off A.J. Pellerino. Inside handoff to number 42, A.J. Pellerino. He's brought down by number 34, Matt Whipple of Lincoln Sudbury, but not before he picked up enough for a first down. That was about a 9-yard run by A.J.
Defensively, Pete, Lincoln Sudbury's been moving Kevin Dolan all over the line, trying to take advantage of what they think the upcoming play is. Every now and then, Acton's burned him by coming back inside of that.
Inside handoff to number 30, Dan Rinaldi. He's going to follow the trap blocking of number 66, Paul Trischetta. Also blocking up front for him was number 55, Sammy Martin, and number 71, Sean Richmond. A pickup of about 4 on the play. It's going to be 2nd and a long 6. We have 3 minutes and 45 seconds left in the half. Ryan Kane's going to drop back to pass. Ball is delivered to number 9, Trey Gullitz. And it's going to fall out of his hands. It looked like it was complete, and then it trickled out of the hands of number 9, Trey Gullitz. That will bring up a 3rd and about 7. Ryan Kane given time by his front 4, and he delivered the ball on the money. But number 9, Trey Gullitz, just couldn't hang on. Good effort on the part of both players. Spilling out to the right would be number 15, Andy Butler. In the slot would be number 35, Chris Mahaney. Inside handoff, off tackle, they have number 42, A.J. Pellerino. He puts another move on. He's going to bring it down to about the 22 of Lincoln Sudbury. Again, one of the things that Coach Mava wanted to do on third and long situations, Bradbury comes in with the so-called nickel defense, an extra defensive back, and he wanted to run it right at him, and there he did. A pickup of maybe 10 on the play. The ball, again, is going to be spotted at the Lincoln Sudbury 23-yard line. We have 3 minutes and 29 seconds left in the half. Acton Boxborough on a sustained drive. Inside handoff to number 42, A.J. Pellerino. He's going to pick up maybe 3 on the play. It'll be 2nd and 7. And in the stop for Lincoln Sudbury was number 63, Matt Trail.
2nd and 8.
I believe Acton Boxborough started this drive at their own 10-yard line. So they are now on a 70-yard march, still 20 yards away from a touchdown. A nice sustained drive here by Acton Boxborough. Here's the pitch outside to number 42, A.J. Pellerino. Driven out of bounds by number 42, Brendan Glass, and number 33, Tyrone Kroon. That's going to be close to a first down. And they're going to bring the chains in. We have 2 minutes and 49 seconds left in the half. It is Lincoln Sudbury 15, Acton Boxborough 7. And the officials are having a conference right here as to whether to bring the chains in. And I guess they are going to bring the chains in. Bringing the chains in, representative from Acton Boxborough are Dave Lee and Mr. Ramos. And here's the measurement for the first down. It's going to be just short of a first down. It will be 3rd down and inches, and the ball spotted at about the 13-yard line, 14-yard line of Lincoln Sudbury. So again, Acton Boxborough on a sustained drive here. Acton Boxborough opened the scoring on a 25-yard TD run by Dan Rinaldi. The extra point was kicked by and successfully by number 10, John Lucas. Then Lincoln Sudbury answered on 2 consecutive scores. On the first TD, they kicked the extra point successfully. On the second, they faked the kick and went for the 2-point conversion, and it was successful. And that brings us up to date with the score 15-7 with 2 minutes and 49 seconds left in the first half. With the long timeout of bringing the chains in, Coach Mavers had a chance to decide what he wants to do. He substituted in number 80, Chris Varney, at tight end. Here's the inside handoff to number 30, Dan Rinaldi. He's going to pull his way up close to the 10. That will be a first down for Acton Boxborough. The ball is spotted just outside the 10. So I don't know if it's, they still have the, I guess it will be first and goal. Well, now they're reconsidering. This is a very important spot here. I don't know if it's first and goal or not, whether they have to score a TD or not. It's very close to the 10. The line markers are still up, so maybe it's not first and goal. Here's the inside handoff to number 42, A.J. Pellerino, following the inside blocking of number 55, Sammy Martin, number 66, Paul Truschetta, and number 71, Sean Richmond. He bowls his way to about the 6.5, so it'll be 2nd and 6. Again, markers are up, so that would indicate to me that it is not a 2nd and goal situation here. It appears they could, by a very slim margin, pick up another first down before they had to score the touchdown. But again, it'd have to be a very slim margin from the perspective I have up here. Here's Kane. It looks like he fumbled the snap. And that will bring up a 3rd and about 8. Again, there's some mud in that portion of the field there. He may have slipped as he tried to disengage himself from the center. And he did fumble the ball. It will bring up a 3rd and about 8. We have 1 minute and 20 seconds left in the half. This would be a very big momentum play, touchdown drive for Acton Boxborough. They put together a nice drive here, and it'd be nice just to put some numbers on the board just before they went in for that's number 35, Chris Mahaney going in motion. A.J. Pellerino is going to break it off on the right side. There is a flag on the play. It is thrown again on the interior portion of the line, which indicate to me holding against the line.
It looked like Acton might have been trying to do two things there, Pete. One, to try to get the first down, but second, to center the ball up for a field goal attempt if they didn't get a first down.
Well, here's a very important penalty going against Acton Boxborough. Here we have offensive holding. Maybe I can find out from my veteran official over here, keeping the clock. Is that a 10 or 15-yard penalty, Mr. Paul? Holding is 10 yards. Thank you, Mr. Paul. I have so much help up here in the booth. It's unbelievable. So that will be a 10-yard penalty assessed against Acton Boxborough. That's going to bring it all the way out to the 18-yard line. So it will be third down and about 18. Again, I think they can get a first. The line markers are still up, so again, it indicates to me they could get a first down before they score a touchdown, but by a very slim margin. Inside handoff to number 42, A.J. Pellerino. He breaks the initial tackle, but then he's going to be brought down by number 56, co-captain Greg Shaw. So they'll be short by a wide margin of a first down. The ball is spotted at about the 14. It's going to bring up fourth and 14. The clock is still running. We have 27, 26, now 25 seconds left in the half.
We'll be looking at a 32-yard field goal here, Pete, if they decide to go for it. No indication at this point.
Yeah, it would appear right now Acton Boxborough is going to let it run down as far as they want and then call time. And they do call time with 7 seconds left. It'll be a charge timeout against Acton Boxborough. So it is, we have 7 seconds left in the half. Lincoln Sudbury up by a score of 15-7. We'll take a brief pause in the action. During that timeout, the official has added 3 seconds to the clock. There will be 10 seconds left. John Lucas is pacing off his steps for the field goal attempt. It will be attempted from the 20-yard line, about the 22. So add on a tack on another 10 for the end zone. It'll be a 32-yard field goal attempt. Here's the snap. It's up. It's going to be blocked. It was blocked by number 57, Brian Marabella of Lincoln Sudbury. So the 32-yard field goal attempt will be nullified. 4 seconds ran off the clock. There'll be 6 seconds left in the first half of Lincoln Sudbury up by a score of 15-7. That was a heartbreaker for Acton Boxborough. They had taken the ball at their own 10-yard line, driven it all the way down. They got as close as the 6 of Lincoln Sudbury. They had a crucial holding call called against them, and they wound up having a field goal block. If they had put some numbers up on the board then, it may have given them a little momentum going into halftime. Acton Boxer will be in their prevent defense. Quarterback Butler will fall on the ball, and that will be the end of the first half with the score. Acton Boxborough trailing by a score of 15-7 to the Lincoln Sudbury Warriors. We'll take a brief pause. As we mentioned in the pregame introduction, tonight here at Acton Boxborough, it is Pop Warner night. At halftime, we'll be introducing all the cheerleaders and young aspiring football players involved in the Acton Boxborough Pop Warner football program. During the introductions at halftime will be the cheerleading coordinator for the Pop Warner Football Association, Mrs. Debbie Sparrow. We'll pick up the introductions over the mic, so we'll leave the mic on, and you'll be able to view the introduction of all the Pop Warner participants.
Michelle Metz, Hillary Brown, Kimberly Murray, Lauren Chillis, Nicole Doherty, Donna Jordan, Jennifer Mark, Marie Pichelli, Susan Chinnick, Pamela Toshik, Trisha Wishart. The Ninja Cheerleaders, also students at RJ Gray Junior High, Stephanie Bass, Alicia Bacon, Jennifer Crumb, Carlos Centoro, Dottie D'Ambrosio,
junior midget team, number 6, Ben Weirdhold. Number 12, Jeff King. Number 21, Dan Coaches. 22, Timothy Plant. 23, Eric Burleigh. 27, Matthew Sucecki. 30, Phil Pirulino. 32, Mike Harvey. 33, Joe Levine. 34, Ryan Moten. 41, Sean Walsh. 47, Craig Everett. 84, Mick Tanner. 54, Nathan Gregory. 56, Carl Hempley. 58, Josh Liu. 61, Andrew McCarrick. 63, Chris Orchard. 65, Brendan Hartwell. 66, David Garber. 70, Zach Thompson. 75, Danny White. 79, Eric. 81, Justin Cole. 85, David Nolan. 87, Ryan Cassidy. 88, Josh Henry. 90, Xander Gurnell. The Atkins Midget football team, the leading New England champions at the B level. Number 7, Adam Sullivan. Number 10, Luke Kinney. Number 12, Matt Blakely. Number 14, Brian Vogel. Number 21, Ronnie French. 27, David Lamb. 28, Mike Jensen. 30, Stephen Barney. 32, Jake Close. 34, Ben James. 44, Nick Gould. 45, Mark Rudenko. 56, Sean French. 63, Tim Patton. 64, Nick Kroll. 67, Tim Pat Martin. 71, Mike Eubanks. 74, Ken Wake. 76, Max Brissett. 77, Darren Valencia. 88, Gardella. 85, Brian North. 87, Rob Little. 99, Scott Curtis. Ladies and gentlemen, the 1991 Atkins Boxborough Pop Warner football team.
You have just witnessed the introduction of the Pop Warner participants. The future bodes very well for Acton-Boxborough High School. The program is thriving under the direction of color analyst, president of the Pop Warner Association, Mr. Burke Allred. Now we're going to be entertained by a combined cheer of the Acton-Boxborough varsity cheerleaders, joined by the midget and junior midget cheerleaders for Pop Warner. You've heard the introduction of the junior midget and midget cheerleading squad. I'll now introduce the varsity cheerleaders for Acton-Boxborough. We have Amy Herman, assistant captain Lydia Richardson, co-captain Jane Lennard, co-captain Stephanie Smith, assistant captain Stacy Susie Sundberg, Colleen Fenton, Jean Suprell, Betsy O'Brien, Laura Bartlett, Sydney Rush, Laura Quasmanen, Heather Russell, Jason Breslau, Amy Pompers, Kathy Hosmer, Candace Bartlett, Amanda Exaros, Bianca D'Ambrosio, with the O accentuated. The coach of the varsity cheerleaders is Coach Donner Sims. And that was a great job done by the combined group of the midget and junior midget cheerleaders. They were joined by the varsity cheerleaders of Acton-Boxborough. Now the varsity cheerleaders are going to entertain us once more here at halftime with the score, Lincoln Sudbury 15, Acton-Boxborough 7.
Thank you.
Another great job done by the Acton Boxborough varsity cheerleaders, and well appreciated by the big crowd here at Acton Boxborough.
Games, Acton has had the better hand with the statistics. Unfortunately, they're not up on the scoreboard. Acton had four times in the first half to Sudbury's three. Dominated on the clock, 11 and a half minutes to 10 minutes. Acton outgained Sudbury 165 yards to 106, running off 31 plays to Sudbury's 22. Acton also had nine first downs to Sudbury's seven. We've seen ball control by both teams pretty much sticking to their original game plan of being able to establish a ground game and then move to the air when they had the ground game set up. As we said before, the score is 15-7. Acton's going to regroup at halftime and hopefully come back out and move the ball on the ground and then be able to throw the ball.
Thanks, Burke, for the updated halftime stats. Now we're going to enjoy the halftime entertainment provided to us by the exceptional Acton Boxborough High School Band. Let's listen in. Now joining the Acton Boxborough High School Band is the Junior High Band. And we'll have a combined effort by the Varsity Band of Acton Boxborough, now joined by the Junior High Band. Doing an excellent job as always.
God bless the USA.
An outstanding job done by the combined efforts of the Acton Boxborough High School Varsity Band along with the Junior High Band. The Acton-Boxborough combined efforts of the high school band joined by the junior high band received a fine ovation from the nice large crowd here. We're at halftime of the Acton-Boxborough Lincoln Sudbury varsity football contest with Lincoln Sudbury up by a score of 15-7. We'll return after a brief pause in the action. Right, we're about to pick up second half action here. We're with the score, Lincoln Sudbury Warriors 15, the Acton Boxborough Colonials 7. TD runs in the first half. Acton Boxborough jumped out first on a 25-yard TD scamper by tri-captain Dan Rinaldi. The extra point was good by number 10, John Lucas. It brought the score to 7-0. Lincoln Sudbury came back with an answer. The TD was scored on a 4-yard run by number 33, Tyrone Kroon. The extra point was kicked by number 25, Kevin Bedard. Lincoln Sudbury came back again, and the touchdown was again scored by number 33, Tyrone Kroon. The attempt for extra point, they had a fake kick. The two-point conversion was good. That brings us up to date with the score, Lincoln Sudbury 15, Acton Boxborough 7. Acton Boxborough will kick off the second half. Teeing up the ball for Acton Boxborough is number 10, John Lucas. Back deep to receive for Lincoln Sudbury is number 42, Brendan Glass, and number 33, Tyrone Kroon. We have a very large crowd on hand today. Estimates are around the 3,500 mark. Lucas's kick is going to be fielded by number 42, Glass. He's going to field it at about the 25. He's going to bring it out to about the 37-yard line, about a 12-yard return by Brendan Glass. It'll be first and 10 for the Warriors at their own 32-yard line.
Got a little help from last night's rain on that tackle, Pete. May need a couple more of those.
The handoff is going to go to number 42, Glass. He's going to be brought down by number 35, Chris Mahaney, joined by number 34, Jason Brady. A pickup of maybe 2.5 on the play. It's going to bring up 7.5. And the ball is spotted at the 35-yard line. It'll be interesting to see what kind of adjustments both coaches made in the locker room at halftime. Here's pressure going to be put on. He's initially going to be hit by number 80, Chris Varney, joined by outside linebacker number 52, Devin Colloy, and number 66, Paul Truscetta. And quarterback Andy Hunter is going to be thrown for about a 7-yard loss, maybe a 10-yard loss. It's going to bring up third and about 17.
Sudbury caught gambling that time. Fortunately for Acton, they were able to have good pressure on the quarterback and made a sack.
Here's the reverse going to number 42, Glass. He's going to be pursued from behind by number 80, Chris Varney.
Glass on the carry. Tackled by Chris Varney.
The tackle was number 66, Paul Truscetta, along with number 71, Sean Richmond. A gain of maybe 2 on the play. It's going to bring up fourth and about 15. Maybe 17 to go. Back deep to receive. The anticipated punt will be number 34, Jason Brady. In punt formation is number 33, Tyrone Kroon. A nice high spiral. It's going to be fair caught successfully by number 34, Jason Brady. That is the first time that Acton Boxborough has stuffed the Lincoln Sudbury offense and forcing a punt. The only other turnover was a fumble on a nice drive by Lincoln Sudbury. It was recovered by number 66, Paul Truscetta, early in the first quarter. So it'll be first and 10 for Acton Boxborough at their own 37-yard line. Kane will continue operating at quarterback for Acton Boxborough. Here he is on the bootleg. He's going to pick up a block by number 66, Paul Truscetta. There's a fumble on the play. It's going to be recovered by number 66, Paul Truscetta. In and a hit for Lincoln Sudbury was number 41, Chuck Rice, and number 54, Kevin Dolan. So there will be a loss of about 6 on the play. It'll be second and 16.
Mm-hmm.
Inside handoff will go to number 30, Dan Rinaldi. He finds a big hole on the right side, opened up by his right tackle, number 78, Paul Sweeney, and right guard, number 66, Paul Truscetta. A pickup of about 8 on the play. It'll be 3rd and 8 at the Acton Boxborough 39-38 yard line. We have 8 minutes even left in the third quarter. Kane inside handoff to A.J. Pellerino. He breaks it out. A nice bit of running there. He kept his balance. It looked like he was ready to trip. And he's going to pick up a first down across the midfield stripe into Lincoln Sudbury Warrior territory. The ball is going to be spotted at about the Warrior 47.
As we saw in the first half, Pete, Acton elected to run the ball on third and long to the outside and take advantage of the nickel defense of Sudbury.
Another fine call by Coach Maver, sending A.J. Pellerino, and he gained about 12 on the play. The ball is now spotted at the Lincoln Sudbury 47. Here's Ryan Kane on the bootleg action again, delivering the ball here to number 42, A.J. Pellerino. It's going to fall incomplete, and in the coverage for was number 33, Tyrone Croom. That will bring up a 2nd and 10 at the Lincoln Sudbury 47-yard line. Reporting into the Acton lineup is number 15, Andy Butler. He's going to replace wingback number 35, Chris Mahaney. Also in the lineup is number 88, Adam Morin. Inside handoff, straight up the gut, is going to be carried by number 42, A.J. Pellerino, following the interior blocking of center number 55, Sammy Martin, along with number 66, Paul Truscetta, and tri-captain number 71, Sean Richmond. A pickup of about 7 on the play. It's going to bring up a 3rd and a long 2.
Ball started at the 40-yard line of the Warriors.
Hand off to A.J. Pellerino. He followed the tackle off the right side. Blocking provided by number 78, Paul Sweeney, and right guard number 66, Paul Truscetta. He's going to pick up about 5 on the play. That will be enough for a first down. The ball is now spotted at the Lincoln Sudbury 34-yard line, 1st and 10.
Acton doing what they do best, running the ball right up the gut at the defense of the Sudbury Warriors.
Well, another great thing about this drive, it keeps the Lincoln Sudbury offense off the field, a very explosive offense that we've observed in the first half. Kane on the inside handoff to number 35, Chris Mahaney. He's going to pick his way up to about the 33-yard line. It'll be a pickup of about 2 on the play. It'll be 2nd and 8. We have a very large crowd on hand here. They're starting to block the yard markers on the sideline there, so if I'm a little slow in picking up the yard markers, please bear with me. A real nice crowd on hand for this very important Duke County League action. Here's the pitch outside to number 42, A.J. Pellerino. Initially hit by number 42 and strung out by Brendan Glass. Made the play very slow developing. He was eventually brought down by number 33, Tyrone Croom. There'll be a loss on the play. It'll bring up a 3rd and 10. The ball is now spotted at the Lincoln Sudbury 34-yard line. Nice play there by outside linebacker Brendan Glass of Lincoln Sudbury. She really strung out the play so Tyrone Croom can come up from his safety spot. Here's Kane on the rollout going to the right. He's going to be brought down by a number in Sudbury tacklers led by number 50, Brett Kawa, joined by number 57, Brian Marabella. There will be another loss on the play. It'll bring up a 4th and about 16. Anticipating the punt of number 10, John Lucas, will be number 33, Tyrone Croom, and number 42, Brendan Glass. Lucas's punt is going to be high, a nice pile, a fair catch by number 33, Tyrone Croom, right at about the 10-yard line. So we've had two possessions by each offense here in the second half, each being stopped. We now have the second possession, the second half of Lincoln Sudbury. We have 4 minutes and 40 seconds left in the third period. Lincoln Sudbury out by a score of 15-7. Operating at nose guard, Acton Boxborough is number 72, Jeff Hool. Inside handoff to number 34, Matt Whipple. He's going to bring it out to about the 17-yard line, a gain of about 7 on the play. He'll bring up a 2nd and 3. The tackler for Acton Boxborough is number 34, Jason Brady.
The ball is spotted at the 16-yard line of the Warriors.
Acton Boxborough going to a more 50 defensive alignment here. Inside handoff again to number 34, Mark Whipple. Is going to be brought out close to the 20-yard line and close to a first down. In the stop for Acton Boxborough is number 71, Sean Richmond, and number 66, Paul Truscella. There will be a timeout for a measurement. 4 minutes and 3 seconds left. We'll take a brief timeout in the action as we wait the chain being brought out. We're back to action here. It will be just shy of a first down after that measurement by the officials. So they'll bring up a 3rd and inches for Lincoln Sudbury at their own 20-yard line. My color analyst is thinking I'm becoming very multiloquent here in the second half. Are you going to look up that word, Berkey?
We'll look that up and report back next week in the pregame show as to what your strategy was with that comment.
The SATs are coming up very soon, Burke, so we got to start preparing ourselves. The inside handoff is going to go to number 34, Mark Whipple. He's going to cross the 20, so that would give Lincoln Sudbury a first down. In the stop for Acton Boxborough is number 72, Jeff Hool. He was joined by number 34, Jason Brady, and number 80, Chris Varney. That will bring up a first down at the Lincoln Sudbury 22-yard line. We have 3 minutes and about 40 seconds left in the third period. Inside handoff is going to go to Mark Whipple again. He's going to be greeted right at the line of scrimmage by number 71, Sean Richmond. He's going to be thrown for a little loss on the play, maybe of 1. It'll bring up a 2nd and 11. Reporting back into the lineup for Acton Boxborough is number 66, Paul Truscella. He replaces number 72, Jeff Hool. We have a flag on the play. Usually if it's thrown and whistled dead before the snap, it's usually offense. It'll be dead ball foul, illegal procedure against Lincoln Sudbury. That will be a 5-yard penalty assessed against Lincoln Sudbury. The ball will now be spotted at about the 17. So that'll bring up the down repeat. It'll be 2nd and about 15. Reporting into the lineup, replacing number 52, Devin Colloy. I think it's number 29, Mike Daly. He's going to be whistled down right there. The official, right on top of the play, felt as though Hunter's knee had touched the ground prior to his pitching the ball to his tailback, number 33, Tyrone Kroom. So he's going to be ruled dead there, which will cause another loss on the play, a loss of maybe another 3. It's going to bring up a 3rd and about 22 yards to go from the Lincoln Sudbury 12-yard line. So Acton Boxborough catching a few breaks here with 2 minutes left in the third period. A penalty and now a trip against Lincoln Sudbury. The ball is going to be delivered out here to number 41, Chuck Rice. He's going to pick up about 11 on the play. He'll be 9 yards short of a first down. And in the coverage for Acton Bucksboro was number 34, Jason Brady, and number 71, Sean Richmond. However, that will bring up a fourth and about eight. Anticipating the punt of Lincoln Sudbury will be number 34, Jason Brady. Back deep to punt for Lincoln Sudbury will be number 33, Tyrone Croom. A tumbling low punt will be fielded cleanly by number 33, Jason Brady. However, he's downed right there. The ball will be spotted at the 48-yard line of Lincoln Sudbury. It'll be first and 10 for the Colonials at the Lincoln Sudbury 48 with 1 minute and 16 seconds left in the third period.
In trading punts here back and forth in the third period, Acton's gradually creeping up the field. We're just about starting here at, the 48-yard line of Sudbury, so we're gaining field position slowly.
There doesn't appear to be too much of a breeze out there. I don't think wind's a factor. Here's Kane on the bootleg. He's going to avoid the initial rush. Now he's going to scramble out here to the left, turn on the jets. And he's going to pick up about 13 on the play, and there's an additional flag on the play. He's going to be driven out of bounds by number 33, Tyrone Croom, and number 42, Brendan Glass. There is a flag on the play, however. We have a clipping call against Acton Boxborough. Was this during the play or after the whistle? It will make a difference because it could be first and 25, or it could be they'll just bring it back 15 yards. It'll be first down again. The officials assessing the situation here. It's definitely a clipping call against Acton Boxborough. It's going to be first down. The first down will remain. And it is a spot foul. So what has happened here, we have a 15-yard clipping penalty assessed against Acton Boxborough. But it was from the spot of the foul after they had picked up a first down. So in reality, what they have here is a first and about 13. And Brady going in motion. Here's Kane on the option. He pitches back to number 34, Jason Brady. Picked up a nice downfield block by number 30, Dan Rinaldi. He's going to pick up of about 9 on the play. It's going to bring up a second and about 4, about 4 for Acton Boxborough. The ball is now spotted at the Lincoln Sudbury Warrior 43-yard line with 35 seconds left in the third period. That's A.J. Pitorino in motion. Inside handoff to number 30, Dan Rinaldi. Right in front of us, it appears he's going to pick up about 5 on the play, enough for a first down. The ball will be spotted at the Lincoln Sudbury 37-yard line. A nice 5-yard gain by tri-captain of the Colonials, Dan Rinaldi.
Pete, as time winds down here in the third quarter, a lot of the boys are sweating heavily on both sides. A lot of dark-colored jerseys out there. We may see who's in shape here in the fourth quarter.
Well, it is a rather strange and warm evening this late in the fall. Here's an inside handoff to number 35, Chris Mahaney. He followed the blocking on the left side there of number 77, Ryan Messina. And that will be the end of the third period with Acton Boxborough trailing the Lincoln Sudbury Warriors by a score of 15-7. We'll be back after a brief pause in the action.
We'll use all their timeouts.
Returning to action here at Acton Boxborough High School, a home dual county league football game, a very important one.
consensus around the league is this will determine the Duke County League champion, which will represent the Duke County League in the upcoming playoff newly instituted system of the MIAA. It is the beginning of the fourth period. The Lincoln Sudbury Warriors are up by a score of 15-7. Acton Boxborough is in the middle of a long sustained drive here. It will be second and seven from the Lincoln Sudbury 34-yard line. Here's the play action pass with the pass delivered out here to number 42, A.J. Pellerino. He's going to pick up enough for a first down. He's going to pick up about nine on the play. He's going to be stopped by number 33, Tyrone Croom. But not before he picked up another first down for Acton Boxborough. Acton Boxborough started this drive on the Lincoln Sudbury 48. There's A.J. Pellerino running it up the gut. Again, he's going to pick up some decent yardage going off his right guard, number 66, Paul Truschetto. He's going to pick up about five on the play. It's going to bring up a second and five. So we have a nice long ball control drive here being executed by Acton Boxborough. It has been Ryan Kane operating at quarterback the entire football game so far for Acton Boxborough. There's a fumble on the play, and it appears Lincoln Sudbury has recovered. A big turnover caused by Lincoln Sudbury right here. Acton Boxborough had brought the ball all the way down to about the 20-yard line, and now we have the turnover. So the big defense of Lincoln Sudbury comes up strong there and causes a turnover. The offense will take over at the Lincoln Sudbury. They're on their 16-yard line, first and 10. The defense needs to come up big right here and cause a turnover of its own. Here's the inside handoff to number 34, Mark Whipple. In on the tackle for Acton Boxborough is number 71, Richmond, joined by teammate number 35, Chris Mahaney. A pickup of four in the play. It's going to bring up a second and six. Again, if Acton Boxborough can continue to play field position here and cause Lincoln Sudbury to punt from the deep in their own territory, they'd have a good shot here tying the score up. Hunter's going to go back to pass. Looks like he had the screen pass set up, but it's going to be smelled out by number 66, Paul Truschetto. Pressure had been put on by number 35, Chris Mahaney. There'll be a loss of about five on the play. A loss of about seven on the play. It's going to bring up a third and 12. Looked to me like Lincoln Sudbury was setting up a middle screen there, and it was smelled out by the interior line of Acton Boxborough. Truschetto had put pressure on, and then he was brought down by Chris Mahaney. Big down right here if they can stop him. Handoff is going to go to number 42, Brendan Glass. He's going to be close to a first down. He's going to be brought down by number 10, John Lucas. It's going to be close to a first down, depending on the spot. The officials indicated it will be short, it'll be fourth down. So a nice effort here by the defense to stuff the Lincoln Sudbury offense deep in their own territory. It'll be fourth and about a long two. The ball is spotted at the Lincoln Sudbury 23-yard line. Tyrone Croom is in punt formation for Lincoln Sudbury. Back deep to receive the anticipated punt is number 34, Jason Brady. Brady comes up, and tried to field the punt on the fly. However, he does recover. And the ball is going to be spotted at the 40. A tough break for Jason Brady. He took the gamble that he was going to field that ball on the fly. And if he had a clear alley going up the left side, and he could have gained numerous yardage. But he fumbled it, but he did refumble his own fumble. There are now 7 minutes and 57 seconds left in the ball game, with Lincoln Sudbury up by a score of 15-7. Oh, Here's the play action pass. Again, the fake inside. The pitch out here to number 42, A.J. Pellerino. He turns the speed on. He's going to pick up about 8 on the play, maybe 9. Again, that second touchdown play by Lincoln Sudbury where they picked up 2 on the extra point can loom very large here. If Acton Boxborough puts one in, they'd have to go for the 2 in the tie. Let me ask the time official over here. Is there a extra session here? Okay, there is no overtime in the Dual County League. So during regulation time, the final score will be it. Here's Kane dropping straight back to pass. He's going to step up and deliver the ball to number 9, Trey Gullitz. He had outdistanced the defenders of Lincoln Sudbury, but the ball was just overthrown by a tad. There was a, you know, basically a free down for Acton Boxborough. It was second and about 1 after the pickup of 9 by A.J. Pellerino on the swing pass. Coach Maven went for it all. Trey Gullitz had outdistanced the Lincoln Sudbury defenders, but Ryan Kane's pass was just a little long.
It's a good call at that point, Pete. There's starting to be a lot of people out there with slow-moving feet from the length of the game.
Yeah, Lincoln Sudbury has about 8 people right up on the line of scrimmage daring Acton Boxborough to put it up. That's number 3, Dan Rinaldi on the carry. The officials are calling time to unravel the pile. It appears there will be enough for a first down. It'll be first and 10, Acton Boxborough, just on the other side of the midfield stripe. We have 7 minutes and 3 seconds left in the ball game. Again, I think Acton Boxborough may want to go back to its first down play action pass here, because again, you can see on film here, Lincoln Sudbury has about 9 people real up close to the line of scrimmage. Again, here's the play action pass by Kane. They took it away. Lincoln Sudbury made a little adjustment of their own, anticipating that swing pass out here to the right. And in the coverage was number 50 of Lincoln Sudbury, Brett Kala. Kane will be thrown for a loss in the play of about 8. It's going to bring up a 2nd and 18. Again, Lincoln Sudbury thinking right along the line. Maver and myself looking for that play action pass. They tried to swing the ball out here again to A.J. Pellerino. Lincoln Sudbury anticipated it very well, made the adjustment, and denied Kane that alley and threw him for an 8-yard loss. Inside handoff to number 42, A.J. Pellerino, still on his feet. He's going to drive the ball back to about the original line of scrimmage. That'll bring up a 3rd and 10 for Acton Boxborough at just about the midfield stripe. In the tackle for Lincoln Sudbury was number 40, David Wren. Well, they gave Acton an unfavorable spot there. They put it at about the 48 of Acton Boxborough. It's going to bring up a 3rd and 12. Just putting out wide to left will be number 9, Trey Gullitz. In the slot will be number 42, A.J. Pellerino. Here's the fake to Brady. He's going to step up and deliver it to number 30. Rinaldi. It appears he's going to pick up about 13 on the play, enough for a first down. It'll be 1st and 10 for Acton Boxborough at the Lincoln Sudbury 39-yard line. In on the stop for Lincoln Sudbury was number 41, Chuck Rice.
The long drives Acton's put together thus far, the Sudbury defenders are barely getting set by the time the ball snapped. They're starting to get weary in there and certainly vulnerable to a run straight ahead of them.
Well, they're a team rich in tradition. Being involved in a close ball game is nothing new to them. Here's Kane rolling out to left. The ball's going to be delivered back here to the right. Incomplete, intended for number 88, Adam Morin. Again, Acton Boxborough sending receivers deep down the left side, trying to draw the attention to the left and then deliver the ball back here to the right. But the pass intended for number 88, Adam Morin, is incomplete.
Clock, incomplete pass. Incomplete. You get the clock running on.
There is a timeout on the field. We'll take a brief pause in the action here. There's a little confusion up here in the booth. They've now reset the clock. There are 4 minutes and 50 seconds left in the ball game. We have 2nd and 10 for for Acton Foxborough. The ball is placed at the Lincoln Sudbury 39-yard line. Ryan Kane appears to be audibling at the line of scrimmage. The handoff is going to go to number 42, A.J. Pitorino. He cuts it back. Pick up about five on the play. That's going to bring up a third and about four. In the stop for Lincoln Sudbury was number 84, Matt Williams. It'll be third and a long four. The ball is spotted just at the 35-yard line of Lincoln Sudbury. We have 4 minutes and 20 seconds left in the ball game, so a key third down possession right here. Acton Boxborough needs to keep the drive alive right here. Kane tried to deliver the ball out to number 15, Andy Butler. He appeared to slip on the turf, could not push off his back foot, or in this case his right foot, and the pass fell incomplete, intended for number 15, Andy Butler. There are 4 minutes and 6 seconds left in the ball game. A big, big fourth down situation here. They convert here, keep control of the ball, and push it in. Here's a big play. Operating a quarterback will again be tri-captain number 12, Ryan Kane. The crowd anticipating that this is a big play, starting to get into it. Kane, given time, he's going to be flushed out of his pocket. He's still alive. He's going to deliver the ball out here. It's going to fall incomplete. The pass was intended for number 10, John Lucas. In the coverage for Lincoln Sudbury was number 42, Brendan Glass. But again, it appeared the interior line of Acton Boxborough had given Kane some time. Then he was flushed out, forced to his left, or his non-throwing side, tried to deliver the ball back. May have slipped on his back foot again with the slippery turf. Tried to hit number 10, John Lucas, but the pass fell incomplete. And Lincoln Sudbury will take over on downs with 56 seconds left in the ball game. The ball is now placed at the Lincoln Sudbury 34-yard line. Defense needs to come up big here and cause a turnover. Here's the handoff to number 42, Brendan Glass. Going to be initially hit by number 34, Jason Brady, then finished off by number 10, John Lucas, and number 71, Sean Richmond. But that's a characteristic that the Lincoln Sudbury backs have shown all night, that they take the initial hit, keep their balance, and are able to pick up two or three extra yards, even though they hit the line of scrimmage. A great job of running all night by the Lincoln Sudbury backs. A gain of four on the play. It's going to bring up a second and six. Acton Boxborough shifting their defense a little bit to going through a 5-3 alignment. Here's Tyrone Kroom going to try to get outside, but a great job of containment on the left side by number 89, Matt Stampski. He strung that play all the way out to the sideline, and then he had the active pursuit from behind by number 80, Chris Varney, and he brought him Tyrone Kroom down from behind. A loss on the play of about two. They'll bring up a third and eight. Again, another big down situation right here. If Acton Boxborough's defense can come up big and cause a punt from Lincoln Sudbury. Hunter going to go back to pass. Delivers the ball right over here to a wide open receiver, number 41, Chuck Rice. He's still on his feet. Acton Boxborough must have had a stunt on right there, because there was no one in the middle of the field defending number 41, Chuck Rice. And Hunter's pass was delivered right on the numbers. Received very well by number 41, Chuck Rice, and they pick up a first down. The ball is placed at the midfield stripe. Lincoln Sudbury will keep control. There are 2 minutes and 20 seconds left in the ball game. Acton Boxborough needs a turnover right here. Inside handoff to number 34, Mark Whipple. Is going to pick up about five on the play. Again, the ability of the Lincoln Sudbury backs to keep their balance and carry defenders on their backs. A pickup of about five. We have a timeout on the field with 2 minutes and 5 seconds left. Lincoln Sudbury 15, Acton Boxborough 7. We'll take a brief pause. We'll pick up the action. Just a reminder, action will resume next week for Acton Boxborough. They'll be playing at Boston against dual County League opponent Boston Latin. Game time 1:30. We have 2nd and 5 from the Acton Boxborough 45. Inside handoff to number 34, Mark Whipple. Again, initially hit by number 52, Devin Colloy, but able to keep his feet and picked up maybe 2 on the play. He was by number 80, Chris Varney, joined by teammate number 66, Paul Truscetta. And Acton Boxborough will take another timeout. There's 1 minute and 57 seconds left in the ball game. Again, we'll take a brief pause in the action.
Acton's tacklers now, Pete, are going to be going for the ball on every play to try to get it back and get something going here.
Well, again, there's still enough time left in the ball game. Ryan Kane has shown that he has the ability to have a strict, quick strike effect. If he can find an open receiver downfield and deliver the ball, they can score in a hurry, but they need to get the possession of the ball here. We have another big third down possession here. It's 3rd and about 4. The ball is placed at the Acton Boxborough 43-yard line. And Lincoln Sudbury call a timeout, realizing, again, they do have a big play down here. Want to make sure they have the correct play called. We'll take another brief pause in the action. As we pick up the action here with the score, Lincoln Sudbury 15, Acton Boxborough 7. We have another big third down. Looks like 3rd and a long 3 for LS. Inside handoff to number 34, Mark Whipple. Again, showing that ability to spin and keep his balance, is going to pick up a first down. Hunter did a fine job of getting that snap off. It looked as though Acton Boxborough had sent number 80, Chris Varney, on a stunt. Just couldn't quite get the Hunter quick enough. And Whipple picked up a big, big first down for Lincoln Sudbury. They now have the ball at the Acton Boxborough 34 with 1 minute and 35 seconds left. Keeping possession right here. Not necessarily going in for a score, but running the clock down. Inside handoff to number 34, Mark Whipple. He's going to be gain tackled by the left side of the Acton defense, led by number 35, Chris Mahaney, number 66, Paul Truscetta, and number 30, Dan Rinaldi. Again, Acton Boxborough is going to use up another timeout. We have 1 minute and 22 seconds left in the ball game. We'll take a brief pause. As we pick up the action here, it'll be a pickup of 1 on the last play. It'll be a 2nd and 9 for Lincoln Sudbury. The ball spotted at the Acton Boxborough 33-yard line. Time is more of a factor here than anything. Inside, here's a play run by quarterback Butler. He's going to pick up about 4 in the play. It's going to bring up another big down, third down situation for Lincoln Sudbury. Acton Boxborough quickly calls another timeout. The head official is now going to indicate timeout Acton. They have, it appears the official's putting up 1 finger. That has, Acton Boxborough has 1 timeout remaining. We'll take a brief pause in the action. As we pick up the action here, there's 1 minute and 12 seconds left in the ball game. It'll be 3rd and about 5 for Lincoln Sudbury at their 34-yard line of Acton Boxborough. A big down. Hunter's handoff to number 33, Tyrone Croom. He's going to be stopped by just about 9 members of the Acton Boxborough team, led by number 34, Jason Brady, being the last guys up, and number 71, Sean Richmond. That's going to bring up a 4th and a long 1. With 1 minute and 6 seconds left in the ball game, Acton Boxborough will spend their last timeout. And we'll have a crucial 4th down situation when we return. As we pick up the action here in another big down situation, it's fourth and a long one for Lincoln Sudbury. A key down right here. Acton Boxborough needs to come up big. Hunter is going to again be initially stopped. There's a fumble on the play. Again, the ability of the offensive backs of Lincoln Sudbury to break the initial hit of Acton Boxborough's defenders. Hunter was initially hit behind the line of scrimmage by number 30, Dan Rinaldi, slipped out of his hands and then picked up enough for a down. We now have 50 seconds left in the ball game. Again, an outstanding job done by one of the running backs of Lincoln Sudbury of evading the initial hit, keeping his feet, keeping his balance, and fighting his way for additional yards. In that situation, picked up a first down. There is a flag on the play. There will be a delay of game penalty assessed against Lincoln Sudbury. There are 35 seconds left in the ball game. Another highly competitive game played here by Acton Boxborough. Their two previous losses have been 1 point each, 1 point differential between North Quincy, a score of 13-12. Acton Boxborough on the losing end of that one. Another loss suffered this year was a 7-6 loss to Division I opponent Arlington. And here it looks like they're going to appear on the short end of a game against Lincoln Sudbury with 30 seconds left. I don't believe Acton Boxborough has any timeouts. I'd like to thank again the members working up here with the booth. We have veteran cameraman Mr. Joe D'Ambrosio. Spotting today's contest has been Mr. John Close. Providing expert color analysis has been Mr. Burke Allred. We have 9 seconds left. The official's just going to count it down. Acton Boxborough has no timeouts. So once again, Lincoln Sudbury has shown that they're a perennial powerhouse. They come in here on the road and beat hometown Acton Boxborough by a score of 15-7. Again, just a reminder that Acton Boxborough's next game will be in Boston against dual county league opponent Boston Latin. Game time 1:30. Hope to catch you there. Thanks again, members of the booth, and we'll see you again next week on our telecast.